Felters and Crafters, and welcome. Today we are going to East Anglia Yarn Festival. It's their third year running it and my first year going, so I'm really looking forward to it. We are in the stunning, gorgeous Norfolk countryside. The sun is shining. I am going to be doing a workshop there today, and I'm also going to be sitting down in the crafty corner at 2 p.m. So let's make a cup of tea and get on the road. So first up is Felt Wildly with the wonderful Lulu and Daisy, and it was so nice for me to actually meet them in person. And so we had a big hug and I started to have a look around their stand. And so they are a dedicated shop to needle felting and wet felting, and they have tons of kits, and they work with the Lady Moth and Anna Potapova. Their stand is absolutely fantastic. I'm going to do things a little bit differently this year. I'm going to do a few interviews later on and try and show you a few different stands that we don't normally look at. So the Lady Moth, she's doing some workshops with them with these gorgeous bird sort of brooches. The Lady Moth style is so distinctive. And then these are the master classes that Anna Potapova does that you can buy through Felt Wildly. You can get the kits, I believe. These are the Feltabulous mats. I love any of these sort of thick wool mats for needle felting. They are really great. And I also like to see kits made up. I think it makes such a difference when you can see the kit all finished and complete. This is a really good masterclass that they've got on their website. So do go and have a look. So they've got some books. This is Romeo Rabbit that I made a while ago. He's got a new little jumper. He's getting up to lots of adventures on Instagram. They also have Hawthorne handmade kits, and these are the egg boxes with this selection of colours, and you can, when you're at a craft fair, I don't know if they do this online, but you can choose 6 colours for £5, which is proving to be really popular. And then they've got some crafty kit and some World of Wool kits as well, so they've got absolutely tons of stuff. And so this is Yarn Tings, and her wool is fantastic. It's so colourful, so bright. So I've seen her at a couple of other shows and I've never managed to speak to her. But today I decided to see if she would answer a few questions, and she said yes. So sorry if the audio is not as clear as it could be, but here we go. These are lovely. Yeah, what do you call that?
Art yarns.
Art yarns.
I make them into necklaces here.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Oh my God, they're gorgeous.
Yeah.
What's the name of your business?
Yarn Tings.
Yarn Tings, that's fantastic. And how long have you been doing this?
This is, I think I opened an Etsy shop.
Oh, well done.
In 2020, summer of 2021.
Oh, so not long then at all.
No. So I had an Etsy shop in 2021, just there.
Recording. Yeah.
I didn't really sell lots of stuff or shout about it. And then spring 2022 I did my first show, which was the Wool Monty.
Okay, yeah.
Wool Monty 2022, and then a month later I did Yarning.
Oh, so was this a hobby for you that you turned into a business?
Not really. It was more an area of research, maybe.
Oh, fantastic.
My background's in theatre making.
Yeah.
And I had written a show about my relationships, and then when I was pregnant I really got into knitting. It became a way of calming me. I had quite severe anxiety, and I thought if I learn to knit I'll be able to keep my baby warm. And then because generally my theatre shows are autobiographical, I was like, this will probably end up being a show. Then lockdown happened and my whole industry closed.
Completely.
And I thought, well, I'll just use this time to research. I applied for an Arts Council grant to develop my process, which I got, which meant I could just I bought undyed yarn, I bought fleeces.
You bought everything?
I bought everything, because I was like, I need to know about yarn, I need to know how it's made, I need to know everything about it. And I was just documenting my process, and like, obviously I had so much yarn.
Yeah.
And I was just showing and like going, oh, this in this, I made this, I've made this, this colour's inspired by this, and people going, can I buy it?
Yeah.
And I was like, yeah.
I think so.
Okay, yeah, sure, if you'd like to. And it sort of grew from there.
So almost accidental.
Yes, in a way. And then I decided, when I sort of lost my day job as a sort of interpreter, so I'd lost my industry,
yeah,
which, you know, has slowly come back, and then I lost my day job, and I was like, okay, that, now I need to make some money. And that's when I was like, yep, okay, let's start doing some shows, let's do this.
And so what are the main ways in which you do sell your items? Is it through shows?
Yeah.
Online?
I do get some online business, but not that much.
Yeah.
People who've known me and met me will order online.
Yeah, so you get repeat.
I now have a, let me find my flyers. I now have a studio shop.
Oh, fantastic.
In West London.
Oh, in West London.
In
wow. Cool.
Yeah.
Excellent.
It's like suburban West London. It's on the Elizabeth line. And I literally officially opened that on Saturday.
Oh, congratulations, because that's hard work as well.
I'm sat there right now.
Yeah.
In a rather empty shop, because a lot of it's here.
Yeah.
But slowly, I'm hoping to be able to have enough stock to stock both really well.
And so is it mainly just you that's doing it all?
Yeah.
With a little bit of
my
help?
My husband does loads of photos for me, but he's also a gigging musician in Jamaica. And so he takes lots of photos and helps me with my Instagram stuff, makes it look a bit more proper.
Excellent.
You know, I'll just stick a really terrible selfie where half my face is missing. But yeah, it's generally just me. I do all the dyeing, I do all the carding. My son and my friend Nina choose amazing colours often to help me with the bats. My son's bats
That's
always
good.
Sell out really quickly.
Really?
Yeah, he's got an amazing eye for colour, and I pay him. I do pay
Fantastic.
Him for his eye, his colour eye.
So what's the best thing about having your own business?
For me, it's generally been about freedom.
Yeah. Flexibility,
and actually, I'm
freedom.
Sort of struggling with the fact that I have a shop now, because it feels like a
it's something that has to be done. Yeah,
yeah. And actually, it's causing me to get eczema again. Like, psychologically, I really struggle with it. But
you can just see how it goes.
The studio space is amazing. I had a friend who's moving to Japan donate all their houseplants.
Oh, wow. So that made it look lovely.
Yeah, and it's just, it feels like a really calming space. I had some friends come the day before the opening and just sit and knit in there.
Yeah.
Which is also what I want it to be. First and foremost, it's a creative space for me to sit and make. And if people want to come in and share in that, you know, even they don't want to buy anything, if they want to sit and knit and just be there to take in the calm and the sun, like, we've got nice big windows.
I shall try and find a picture on your Instagram and pop it up so that people can see. Do you do workshops?
Not yet, but I would like to.
Something
to think
about.
I am doing a workshop in June at the Welcome Collection.
Okay.
About sculptural textiles and mental health. I am, as part of my show about motherhood and knitting, I made myself a giant heart.
Oh, wow.
Which attached by a magnet to my chest. So I knitted myself a new body, basically, to sort of chronicle my journey through motherhood. And so, I'll be doing a workshop
Fantastic.
On that. Not necessarily with knitting, but with any fabrics you have. So that's the beginning of my workshop journey.
Any advice for anyone thinking of starting up their own business?
I realise, looking back, that I had a lot of trust. I trusted myself. I'm not really sure why, but I did. And also, do what you like. Follow. So my background's in clowning as well.
Okay.
And a really great clown mentor said to me, follow the pleasure.
Yeah.
And I did that with this show I was making. It's like, I just want to knit. And she was like, well, then just knit. Follow the pleasure. Don't worry about what other people are doing. What do you enjoy doing?
Yeah.
What bases or fabrics do you enjoy using?
Because
the things that you love, you'll put more energy and heart into, and people will feel that, and they'll see it, and they will see the joy and the pleasure that's gone into it.
Thank you so much. It's been lovely to meet you.
Thank you.
So then I went for a walk around, and just to show you, you know, it's about half 11 now. No, quarter past 11. And it's not too busy, which is really, really nice. So I made my way to where all the workshops are. So this is the workshop I was doing. This is Daisy teaching needle felting next door, which is lovely to see. So this was a beginner Tunisian crochet class with Sophie Herden, and her company is a Spring Snowflake. And I am a really basic beginner crocheter, so it was a little bit over my head. I managed to make, this is what we were sort of working towards, Tunisian squares, and this is Sophie's business. She does kits for wire words as well, but this is one of the other ladies. This is what I achieved at the end of it, so I was really happy. And then I came out and it was sort of lunchtime, just to show you it wasn't too busy, it wasn't too bad. So I popped to have a look around all the stalls now. So next up, this is Susie Jules, and she does on-trend crochet kits. And as you know, I'm into my crochet. Look at the rainbow. Oh, these are all little kits. They're absolutely beautiful. Little blanket there. This is a scarf kit that you could do. And then she has these bags. I may have been tempted. You'll have to wait till later. But there's large bags and there's smaller bags. And so I was looking around, really loving her business. So I asked her if she would say a few words, and she would. So that's great. So we'll talk to her in a minute. This is a temperature scarf because I'm doing a temperature blanket. So I thought that was really interesting. And then these are little kits as well. So really lovely business. Nice to meet you. My name's Philippa. What's your name?
My name's Suzanne.
And what's the name of your business?
It's Susie Jules.
It's absolutely beautiful. I've just had a look around. I really, really love it. So tell me, how did it start?
So it actually started with the name Susie Jules with my mum. So my mum's really super creative as well.
Yeah.
And we literally were just sitting over a glass of wine one night, and my kids were quite small, and I was just wanting to get something with my creative juices going, really. And my mum was the same.
Yeah.
And we just started making things together. So that's kind of where it started. I've always been in textiles.
Fantastic.
So I trained at Winchester School of Art with woven textiles.
Oh, right. So, yeah, definitely. Yeah. All the way through.
Yeah, I've been yarn obsessed ever since, pretty much.
Excellent.
And, yeah, crochet is just something that's evolved and come from that.
And
really,
how long has the business been running?
So, as Susie Jules, it's been a good 10 years.
Wow, brilliant.
So, yeah, we've been going for about 10 years altogether. But it's been a very diversifying, evolving business. We've done lots
yeah.
of things along the way.
Well, I was going to ask, what sort of ways in which do you sell the business? Do you do online classes? Do you do workshops? Do you have a website? How do you sell your products?
Yeah, multi-platforms actually. So I do have my own website, but I also sell through Not on the High Street and through Etsy.
Oh wow, excellent.
And I also do lots of local workshops and courses where in my local area.
Mm.
And I have a YouTube channel, which obviously is where I try and do lots of tutorials and building.
So what's the name of the YouTube channel?
It's Susie Jules Creates.
Okay, yes. That's fab.
Yeah.
And you said you just started TikTok.
Yes, I'm just having a little dabble with TikTok. It's a little bit kind of figuring out how to make it work for me at the moment, what kind of things people want to see, because
obviously
it's lots of short things. So yeah, whether it's just about doing like some stitch examples, or whether it's a little bit behind the scenes, dabbling with a few of
you
those
just
ideas.
Don't know what's going to take,
do you?
Not
quite sure at the minute, but yeah, we'll give it a go and see what happens.
And what's the best thing about running your own business?
For me, I just love that chance to kind of see other people enjoy my creative
Because you
well.
Do kits as
I
well.
I do kits, yeah. So it's really nice to be able to put something together, see someone make it, and actually love what they've made. So having that, and I've also got a teaching background, so actually it's a natural thing for
oh,
me
so
to
it's
want to
all
teach.
Perfect,
yeah.
Then. It's come together nicely.
So lots of things have come together.
Excellent.
So yeah, that's what I enjoy, really seeing people enjoy being creative.
And any advice for anyone wanting to start their own business?
I think definitely just go, you've got to go for it. If you've got that, something you really want to share, something you really want to try,
yeah.
There's no harm in giving it a go.
Yeah.
And definitely trying out a business and seeing where it takes you, really.
Excellent. Thank you so much.
That's
and best
right.
of luck for the rest of the day.
Thank you so much. No problem.
So this is Maggie and me, and it's a lovely company again. It is Chunky Knits and Crochet Kits. So you can do socks. This is a little sort of roll with me, sort of roll neck thing that you put under your coat. Then she's got scarves and hats. It's lovely that it's all kits and it's so easy and you can just purchase it. And really nice bags back there too. So I managed to have a chat with her as well. Hi, my name's Philippa. Nice to meet you. What's
Hello.
Your name?
Hi, I'm Zoe.
And what's the name of your business?
It's Maggie and Me.
And so how long have you been running Maggie and Me?
About 18 months now.
So not long at all?
Not too long, no.
And are you enjoying it here today?
Yeah, very much so. It's our first time here.
Is it? Your first time? It's my first time visiting as well. So how did the business come about?
Well, originally I was a freelance footwear designer.
Oh, completely different.
Yeah, completely different. But that took me travelling all over the world and I wanted to sort of do something that was a bit closer to home.
Yeah.
So I'm still designing accessories, just
yep.
knitting patterns and crochet patterns. Now.
Completely
so,
different
yeah,
way.
Yeah. And
in what ways do you sort of sell your business? Do you have a website?
We have a website, we have an Etsy store, and we go to a lot of in-person events like this one as well.
And do you do any workshops?
Not yet, but it's something we might introduce in the future, definitely.
Excellent.
Especially crochet, we're asked a lot for crochet.
I bet you are, actually. Yeah. It's really, really popular.
Definitely.
What's the best thing about running your own business?
The flexibility it gives you and the people that you get to meet, you know, come to places like that and meet new faces every time.
And is it just you doing your business?
Predominantly me, and my husband helps with the events and the website and all the technical side as well.
Yeah. And what's the, would you say the, not the worst thing, but the negative sides of running your own business?
It can be quite isolating when you're trying to do everything on your own.
And these shows are great for that.
Absolutely, yeah. It's nice to meet the customer and get some feedback and see what people like, what
yeah.
they don't like, what they'd like to change. So that's always really, really nice.
And do you have any words of advice for anyone that might be thinking of starting their own sort of creative business?
Don't think about it too long, just start.
Yeah, just do it.
You can spend years and years planning and over planning, and actually
yeah.
until you start you don't know what's going to work and what isn't, so
yeah.
start
you.
Get some feedback and then evolve.
Yeah, that's fantastic. Thank you so much. Have a good rest of the day.
Yeah, you too. Lovely to meet you.
Thank you. So there we go. I hope you're enjoying these little interviews. It's just something a bit different. So this is Little Gem Feltz, and she goes to a lot of the craft fairs or the wool festivals that I go to. And I'm always super, super impressed with the amount of stuff she has on her stand. She must work so hard. And I chatted to her husband, and he says she works hard and now she's retired doing this than she did when she was working beforehand. And she's always coming up with new ideas, always starting on the next thing. So I love her bags, and the scenes that she does are really good. These pictures you'll see in a minute, they're really big. And she's always sitting at the front needle felting. And she's also got, these are the big pictures, and then lots of these things are kits. These are little book covers, gorgeous little scenes on them, you know, really impressive. And this is new, her little lampshade lights. I think they work so well. They look really good. And I'll show you the one at the end, but little sort of beach scene, skies, flowers. Look at that. Look at the sheep one. Really gorgeous. And these are some of her kits. So Little Gem Felt's really lovely stand. Then I went to meet some of the other podcasters. Look, they were so welcoming and lovely. I had a great time. And then I managed to chat to one of them as well. This is their mascot. So here we are chatting to Becky.
So I'm here with Becky from Becky Knits,
yep.
But also known as, what's the name?
Becky Mundy Artist.
So, and what do you sell with that?
It's a lino print.
Excellent. How long have you been doing that then?
About 18 months.
Oh, fantastic. So not too long. What sort of ways do you sell it? Do you sell it online or events like this?
So I am like exclusively at markets and shows. Yeah, I don't have online just because it doesn't work out for me. Cost effective. Okay. So yeah, exclusively markets. So I'm usually at a market somewhere in Norwich once a month.
Okay.
And that works.
Fantastic. And how did that business come about? Was it because you were creative anyway?
Yeah, so I started I had a small business making children's clothes, and I really enjoyed that. That was something that started during lockdown.
Yeah.
And then as we came out of lockdown, I started selling at markets, and it kind of killed the enjoyment of it.
Okay.
At the same sort of time that I was packing that down, I started doing lino print just for myself.
Yeah.
And just enjoyed it so much that I then just took some along, put it on the stall next to me with,
oh, right.
one of each.
It on the end.
And then from there it just kind of grew. And it's sort of, I'm still very much starting out in the business.
Yeah.
I'm really enjoying it. I have a lot more passion for this.
Yeah, I was going to say, what's sort of the best thing about running your own business?
Flexibility.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
That's my key word, flexibility.
Yeah.
any words of advice for anyone who would like to start up their own creative business?
I would say maybe talk to some people in the community that you're looking to sort of be involved with. And just talk to them, see what works for them. And like maybe don't expect too much to start off with. Like, you know, it takes time to build a business.
I agree with that, absolutely.
Definitely.
When I said, like, even starting Etsy, it's a slow burner.
Yeah.
I always say it's a slow burner. Just take a year.
Yeah.
Just do it
slowly. And like, some people are incredibly lucky and it's, you know, it happens really quickly for them.
Yeah.
And that can, I definitely sort of give you a false sense of how quickly
it
can happen. But
time.
Yeah, it can take a really, really long time. I would say more often than not, it takes a really long time to get going. So, yeah.
Right, fantastic. We're going to go visit your stand in a bit. So thank you so much.
Yeah.
So here is the corner of craft and chromatic yarns, which is Hannah, who, there she is, I follow on YouTube. And she does beaded stitch markers, of which I have some, and absolutely stunning colourway dyes with all her yarns. And obviously I'm not familiar with all the wool types, but I thoroughly appreciate all her wools. Seems like she has been working really hard. She had so much stuff out, so I hope she had a really good show. But yeah, she's got some amazing colours. I very nearly picked up a few. There's some sparkly ones. I did restrain myself from doing it. But yeah, lovely to see her there. And then this is 80 skeins. But what I really love is the display units as well here, along with all the colourways. So yes, all the stands, just really impressive to see. And so next up, we went to the Left Hookery, which is Tamsin. And every time I went to see her, so I've mentioned her before, I've brought her kits before, and people that follow me, they know it's on my vlog. But every time I went to see her, she was really, really busy. So, and she was on her own, the poor thing. But she does gorgeous crochet, chunky crochet kits. So I've had some of these basket kits, and then I've bought some more of the recycled cottons, I think you'd call them. But look at these, she does bags. Oh, I'm eyeing these up for the future. These are really gorgeous, and the straps are stunning that go with it, and they're a kit, so you can purchase those. And then see those hanging flower pot things as well, and then the mini baskets too. But I managed to have a chat with her. So hi. To meet you. My name's Philippa. You are
Tamsin.
And what's your business called?
My business is called The Left Hookery.
And what do you sell?
I sell modern super chunky crochet kits and yarn and patterns.
Excellent. So how long have you been doing this?
I've been doing it since about 2019, just before COVID.
Not that long then?
No.
And how did it come about?
We moved back to the UK from the Middle East.
Yep.
And for the first time in my life, I wasn't working. I'd moved to a place I didn't know anybody. I got a book out of the library and taught myself to crochet. And then I crocheted a lot of things.
Yeah.
And my husband thought it would be nice if other people enjoyed them as opposed to just us. So
you had too many at home, didn't you?
Yes. So then I started selling just the made finished products in some shops. People were asking me how I made them. I started making kits, and then lockdown happened, and I was picked up by Not on the High Street, and it just took off. People were crafting for the first time in a long time. They had that time to sit down and do their stuff. So
absolutely. Yeah. And that was it. It was so busy on her stand. It was lovely to see, and I hope she had a good second day as well. So that's The Left Hookery with Tamsin. Definitely recommend her kits. So this is the Camel's Yarn, and actually Tamsin mentioned she had some wool from this lady, but the wool is so beautiful. The colours, look at it, they're stunning. That she said she just goes to the drawer and looks at the wool. She hasn't done anything. I think I would probably do exactly the same, because I really nearly bought one. I'll show you at the end. But inspired by Cornwall, and you can definitely see the inspiration. All the colours, they're just fantastic. They look absolutely stunning and beautiful together. And loved all the shawls and everything that was made up. And I know that she does advents, so she spends a lot of time from summer onwards doing advents. So she doesn't do too many festivals. Look at these little swatches she's made up of all the items. And my favourite wools were these colourways above. Look, that's just me, and I probably will buy some in the future. And then next up we have Emily Cross Ceramics. Now, I have shown you her stuff before at other festivals, and this is her dragon. She does beautiful yarn bowls. That dragon, she had another one at one of her shows before, and she'd just finished it the night before, I remember. I love the designs. I think they're stunning. These bowls are really heavy, and I think you put your wool in them and then it feeds out. I particularly like that one there. Look at that. It's beautiful. And she had just finished this large piece, which was really beautiful, and there's a little bit of gold on it. So yeah, really great festival. Thoroughly enjoyed it. It was time to go. It was nearly 4 p.m. and I had a 3.5 hour drive back. Made my way back with the sun shining through the stunning Norfolk countryside, managed to catch a nice shot of the daffodils, and we're just going to have a little chat and talk through what I purchased. So I got a cup of tea and it's the next day. I'm back. It took me 4 hours to get back. I had to stop and get you that picture, that daffodil scene. It was absolutely beautiful, so I turned around and went back and got that shot for you. Yes, it is Mother's Day today, but I like to do these things whilst they're fresh in my mind. We've walked the dogs and it's raining and miserable, so apart from doing a bit of crochet and felting, I thought I would get on here and talk to you. I had a fantastic time. A massive thank you to the ladies that let me interview them, because it's, number one, it's immensely hard work for them. A couple of them were on their own as well. And for me to rock up and just say, can I ask you some questions about your business, please? And they said yes. So a massive thank you. Sorry if the noise wasn't perfect. It was the best I could do. And I'm not a professional interviewer, but I really enjoyed it. It was a really lovely yarn festival to go to, because I got a podcast special sort of thing, and it was really great because Laura gets podcasters and vloggers and what they can do for the festival and how they can promote it, and providing a little area for us to sit together as well. Yeah, really great. And Laura, the work that she puts into it is immense, so a massive thank you. I will just show you a couple of things that I bought, and I didn't buy much, but what I did buy was a couple of really special things. So this is 6 stitch markers. They're from Emma Ball originally, Emma Ball Designs, which I really, really like. So I just thought they were a really good price for 8. I'll do a little close up for you. But yeah, they were really cute, and the name of the stand that I bought them off. So next up, I purchased a Sunburst crossbody bag. So it's a little bag that you can put across your body. It's a crochet kit from the lady I interviewed, Susie Jules. So that's lovely. I'm looking forward to doing that. And then next up, I bought, now this is from the Weavers Guild at the end, and it's coarse spun natural Leicester long wool. I have no idea who made it. The lady that made it just dropped it off with them this morning and left. So Wensleydale coarse spun. But you guys, if you follow me, you know that I love making sheep out of these, and the prices were brilliant. Oh, sorry, the crossbody kit I think was £25. I think, I'll double check, I'll put it up if I was wrong. And so this was £10, and then this was another sort of really big one, and it is a bit of an unusual colour, it's a bit more orangey, it's coming out brown, and this was £12 for absolutely loads of it. It doesn't have a label of what breed it is on it, but yeah, so those two, I just can't resist things like that, even though technically I've got loads and I don't need them. And then this is the show guide, which really helps me. So the last thing is by Emily Cross Ceramics. And I did it, people. Oh my God. I bought a yarn bowl. Is that what you call them? So you put your yarn in there when you're crocheting or knitting, and you feed it through there, and it stays there because it's so heavy. It's like really, really heavy. And it sort of unravels for you. And I've really been needing this with all the crochet I do when I'm sitting down. And I've seen her work before and I absolutely love it. It's so beautiful. And I had a long chat with her. She's from Australia. She did pottery a long time ago. And then she's picked it up again, not recently, but she's picked it up later on in life. And she's doing really well. Her bowls are stunning. They were the dragon ones that I've shown you before. But this is slightly green and it's got hares. I would say hares, definitely not rabbits on it. And it was £50. So it's my biggest present to myself of late, but I am super happy with it. It's beautiful. So for the ladies I interviewed, I have linked their businesses in the description below so you can get straight to their websites or wherever they sell their items. For everybody else, I've put the name on the screen, and if you just search in Google, you should be able to find them. If you have any major issues, come back to me and I will search through the directory that I have. Oh, and just to say, I was also interviewed by a couple of the other podcasters there. So I follow Ali on Little Drops of Wonderful. And so when I saw her, it was like me seeing a YouTuber. I was like, oh my God, I follow her. And then she came over and did a little piece on my needle felting stuff. So that was really amazing. And then a couple of other ladies did as well. So I was desperately trying to work out who they are and follow them. So yeah, it was really lovely to meet up with other podcasters like that. So I hope you've enjoyed this, and if you're new to my channel, please do subscribe. It's free, people. And I will put up my playlist here of all my other wool festivals. Primarily, I do needle felting, but I also have a section on if you're interested in setting up your own business, which is why I'm sort of into interviewing people about their businesses, and I'm a bit nosy and curious about things like that. So do go and have a look at that if you're interested in setting up your own business. But thank you for watching and being here, and we'll see you again soon. Take care, everybody.